Hello. In this video, you'll learn why everyone should use Google Analytics, even on a brand new site, how to sign up for a free analytics account, and how to install the Google Analytics tracking code on your website. All right, let's get started. Google Analytics is an incredibly powerful and user-friendly tool that can tell you pretty much anything you want to know about your website visitors. See what pages are most popular and see how much of your traffic comes from Google, social networks, referral traffic, and paid marketing campaigns. Learn where your users live and how engaged they are with your content. And you can even create custom events and track goals like video views, button clicks, file downloads, and form conversions. Signing up for a Google Analytics account is easy. Just go to analytics.google.com. Log in with your Gmail address. And just click Start Measuring. When you first sign up, you'll be asked to create an account, which is really a sub-account. So this seems like a good time to look at how analytics accounts are structured. At the top level, you have your admin level account, one per Gmail address. The next level is accounts. You can create multiple accounts within your admin level account, each of which can contain up to 50 properties. How you organize your analytics account is a personal preference. To read Google's advice on account structure, click the link in the video description below. People who own lots of sites might make each site a property grouped by theme in one or more accounts. I typically put my large sites in their own account and group my smaller sites together in a single account. In this case, I'm just going to name the account after my website, which is SetupCW. You can opt into their data sharing and data collection practices. Typically, I uncheck these two and leave the other two enabled. And now you need to create a property. You can have multiple properties per account, and you can track multiple properties on a single website. In this case, I'm just going to call mine setupcw.com number one. You'll also want to set your reporting time zone to where you live. Now, by default, you'll be creating a V4 Analytics property, which is the most recent version of Google Analytics. It was released just in the second half of 2020, and it's a big shift in the way Google Analytics works. But hidden in the advanced menu, you still have the option to create a universal analytics property, which is the previous version of GA, originally launched in 2012. For this demo, we'll create a property for each version, and yes, you can track both versions on a single website if you want. If this is your first site, I recommend you go with V4, which is the future. You can always downgrade to universal analytics later if you want to. I also recommend you enable enhanced measurement for your Google Analytics 4 property, which will let you automatically track events like video views, link clicks, downloads, and more, with no configuration required. So click Next, and you'll be taken to a screen that asks you for information about your business. You can choose an industry category if you want, and a business size. This is totally optional, but it helps benchmark your site against other sites in your industry if you want. So let's click Create. And you'll just have to accept Google Analytics Terms of Service, as well as the Data Controller Protection Terms. Right away, we'll be taken to our newly created V4 web property. In the top right corner there, you'll see our new measurement ID, which is all we need to install our tracking code. And you'll notice that it starts with a G dash, which means it is V4 Analytics. Universal Analytics properties start with a UA dash. All right, let's get this tracking code installed on our site. A lot of you will opt to install the analytics tracking code using a plugin just because it's quick and simple. And if you search for Google Analytics in the WordPress plugin repository, you'll have tons of options. I like to go with a plugin that is mostly about getting the tracking script installed, and it doesn't have a lot of bulky features that I don't need, like seeing stats in my WordPress dashboard and stuff. I don't need that. So I prefer to avoid plugins like Monster Insights or Google Analytics Dashboard. It's just not something I need. Two plugins I do recommend are GA Google Analytics and CAOS Host Google Analytics Locally. And I'll show you how to get those installed now. One good lightweight plugin is the GA Google Analytics plugin. So we can just install. It supports V4 Analytics as well as Universal Analytics. And you can just install and activate and go to settings. And to install your code, you can choose either Universal Analytics, which is the previous version, or Global Site Tag, which is V4. So I'll show you how to install V4 Analytics right now. So we'll go to Plugin Settings, and you can see you can choose your tracking method, and we want Global Site Tag, which is V4. And we just have to copy and paste our analytics tracking ID in here. So to get that, let's go back to our analytics account. And we'll go to our V4 property here. And to get your tracking code, all you have to do is go to admin settings down here and just go to setup assistant and you can click on tag installation. And we want to install the tag for our web property that's already been created. So we'll click this, and it gives us the code right here. So what we need, all we need right here is our measurement ID. If you're using a plugin, you don't need this actual code down here. So we'll go back to our site and just paste our tracking ID. And we want it to be loaded in the header. That's good. And optionally, you can disable the tracking of admin level users. So we don't want to track people who are signed into the site. We only want people that are signed out. So that's a good idea. And we'll save changes. All right, now to confirm that your tag is installed correctly, you actually need to open it in a different window where you're not logged into your WordPress site. So I'm going to use a different browser entirely to test this. All right, so I loaded the page in Firefox, and we'll go to View Page Source. And if you just go Control F to search, and we'll type gtag, and you can see that the Google Analytics code is being installed right here, and it's gtag, which is the V4 Analytics. If you're into speed optimization, you should check out the plugin Host Google Analytics Locally, which lets you actually host the Google Analytics script on your own site. It's saving you an external request and maybe improving page speed scores. So we'll go to install now, activate. And in our installed plugins, we'll deactivate the old. And we'll go to CAOS settings. And as you can see, it's really easy to install your analytics tracking ID here. By default, it's showing you a universal analytics ID, but you can also use V4 Analytics. So if we just paste the same tracking code we had in before. So one important tip here is if you're going to be using the V4 Analytics, which any tag that starts with G dash whatever, you need to go to advanced settings and change this where it says which file to download. Analytics.js is the previous universal analytics, and we want gtag.js. And we'll click Save Changes. And you can see now the script source, we have gtag.js, but it's being loaded by CAOS instead. But you don't actually need an analytics plugin at all. So why don't you take a quick second, hit that like button, and I'll show you a couple other ways to install this tracking script directly on your website. So let's go to my universal analytics property and tracking info. So we'll do it with the universal analytics code this time. All right, so here's the tracking script, and how do we get this into our website? All right, so let me show you a couple other ways you can add this tracking code to your site without using a Google Analytics plugin. So one is if you have a theme that lets you inject code into your, that has hooks that let you add code to the header or footer of your theme. For example, GeneratePress has the elements function in GeneratePress Pro, and we can just add a new element, call it a hook. And we want to hook it to WP head, and we can just grab our tracking code from our property here. We're using the universal analytics tracking code. Copy and paste the hook as it is. You can even add a little comment so that you know that it was injected by GeneratePress. Then we go to display rules, and we want to display on the entire site. We can exclude admin. So we only want to show it to logged out users, and we'll hit publish. And that's it, it's installed. Now, even if your theme doesn't have this functionality, you can do it with a plugin. So let's add a new plugin. And this will let you put any kind of tracking scripts that you need for other plugins or other tools and put it right into your theme header. So we'll go with header, footer, and post injections. Install now and activate. And if you go to settings down here, and you can go to header and footer. And now you can see right here, there's a section that says head page injection on every page. Just copy and paste our code, click save. And that's literally it. That's all you have to do. Now, since we are currently browsing the site in a logged out browser, we should be able to see our analytics show up in our account. So if we go back here, and you can see we have one active user browsing the site in real time, which is me. So that means the tracking script is installed and working properly, and you should start getting full data within 24 to 48 hours. All right, I think that's it for this video. If you'd like me to make a video about how to track custom events and conversions in Google Analytics, hit that like button and tell me in the comments. And if you want seriously fast hosting, check out Cloudways Managed VPS. You can use my link, which is cwdeal.com, to get their truly free trial with no credit card required. Plans start at $10 per month, and it's way faster and half the price of my SiteGround Go Geek plan. If you got a suggestion for a future video, please let me know in the comments. And until next time, just keep building.